I think I'm doing a mountain painting, but I kind of forget. Hello. So glad you could join us today. Today we're going to be painting a happy little painting, like these ones here, done by me. Hello, and welcome back. Thank you for coming back for video number two. Today we will be painting with Bob Ross and Kate LaCrosse. I have an episode of Bob all set, and I have all my brushes. I don't know if you can see them. I don't feel like looking. And I have my paints. And all my supplies, so let's paint a happy little painting. First, what I'm gonna do, because I know he always starts off his videos with already having a liquid white base, so that's what I'm gonna do first. So what I do, I just like put it on the canvas. I'm not sure if that's like right, but whatever. I live right near an airport, so I apologize for all of the loud planes. It's so rude.
So rude.
Oh my god. I just killed a bug. Okay. Now that we've got that all set, I'm just gonna clean this brush and we're gonna get started. I like barely haven't painted yet, and I already have paint all over me because I just was washing my brushes. I probably shouldn't be wearing a white shirt either, but Bob doesn't wear a smock, so I don't wear a smock. And just beat the devil out of it. It's harder than it looks.
Whoa.
She's clean though. That's a great technique, Bob. Love you. So I have no idea what you can see and what you can't see because my camera setup is so ratchet. I literally have a chair, a bucket, and a selfie stick taped to the bucket with my phone in it. Because I have a nice camera, but I don't have a tripod, and the camera was really pissing me off because it wasn't recording me. It like would just stop after 30 seconds, and this painting isn't gonna take me 30 seconds, so I don't know what you can see and what you can't. Maybe I should look. Oh, so you can. I have my seltzer. Seltzer's a must, and I have a straw, not a plastic one. Save the turtles. I love you. If you want to go check out that video, Bob Ross has his own channel. It's not actually him because he's dead. But if you want to go check out that, see how to do this painting actually like correctly, season 10, episode 1, you're welcome. So first, I'm gonna not pay attention to what he's saying. That's a great idea. No, but I'm going to put all my paints out that I need. I would just like to point out to the haters that I actually can paint decently. Is that a word? Yeah. So this is my first ever painting. Not too shabby. Literally Bob taught me, so don't think that just because you watch Bob you won't be able to paint. You can do whatever you want and Bob will help you. Then I have this one. This one's not that great because I had poopy brushes, but this is like one of my latest ones. I have another one that's like a seascape that my mom likes so much, so she hung it in her bedroom. So to the haters out there, I'm capable of painting. So first we need titanium white. As you can see, I have like none left. These sisters. The only difference between the liquid white and the titanium white is that the liquid white obviously is more liquidy. I didn't need to tell you that. You could have figured that out on your own. A true artiste. I already got this everywhere. Yeah, usually you need a lot of white. Phthalo green, but I don't have that. So I'm gonna use sap green because greens are greens, whatever. I'm pretty sure phthalo green has like more blue in it, but this one's fine.
Lily!
Look at the camera, you bitch. Thank you. Bye. Another Bob favorite, phthalo blue. Iconic. We love you, Bob. Just as I suspected, the liquid white is not liquid anymore because it's dried because I'm stupid. I'll just redo it, whatever. Now we need Prussian blue, which is like a sky blue. Now we need midnight black. But I don't have that, so I have lamp black, but black is black, so. Now we need dark sienna. I'm not sure what that is. The alizarin crimson, another Bob favorite, but I don't have that. But who's surprised? I have cadmium red. I know how to read. Yeah, so I'm gonna use red. I'm gonna use red. Now we need sap green. I need two green colors, but I only have one, so I'm only using one, okay? Now we need cadmium yellow. See, I know how to say it now. And this is it! This is like the first one I've had. Now we need yellow ochre. Another one I have. Oh, that one looks like diarrhea. So we need Indian yellow because apparently there's like 5,000 types of yellow in this world, but I don't have an Indian yellow. Okay, and that's all our colors. That was painful. We're going in with a phthalo blue to create our sky. I don't know why I'm talking like that. That's annoying. So I'm just taking a little phthalo blue here. You hear that? What is that voice? Who is that? Okay. So I have my phthalo blue on the brush, and from all my Bob experience, I have learned that he always starts with phthalo blue, and he always starts with the sky, and he always does crisscross shapes. So that's what I'm going to be doing today. Watch closely. Watch and learn, all right? I'm the artiste here. Oh, forgot to tap it. Oh, I'm so scared. So mine already does not look like Bob's. Ah! It was a bug, in case you were wondering. Okay, so now I'm gonna blend my sky because this looks like trash, so. Ew! So he has phthalo blue and phthalo green, and I'm not really sure what he's doing. Every time I say phthalo green, I always think CeeLo green. It's funny. Once again, I do not have phthalo green. I'm gonna take the sap green, just a little bit. I really feel as though this is not the color that Bob wanted me to make, but I don't know how to mix colors, and I don't have all the right ones. So, Bob. What's going on my thumb? Oh, so he's making water. Gotcha. Gotcha, Bob. Now my sky is where I want it to be. I just added some like darker spots and lighter spots. The most important thing about a sky, I think, is blending, because obviously the sky is kind of like, you know, because because that's what the sky is kind of like. We're making clouds. For clouds, usually I use the 1-inch brush, and you always go into titanium white, and you just want to drag it down like that. Again, I have no idea what I'm doing. This is just what Bob tells me to do. And now we're gonna do some fluffy clouds because it's a fluffy cloud kind of day. There's fluffy clouds right now, oh my god. I'm feeling so inspired. Okay. I forget how to do clouds, so let's watch Bob. I'm just gonna check to see what he does because, again, he's the real artiste. Just as I suspected, we're doing a mountain. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of the black, get that on my knife, go into the Prussian blue up here, put a little bit of brown and a little bit of red in it. Sounded like the peanut butter baby. So now Bob says we have to make a big decision because we have to decide where our mountain wants to go. And this right here is our mountain. And we're gonna do it. We're gonna mountain it up, all right? Now that I've blended the mountain, we can add like the details in the snow. Taking a 1-inch brush and tapping this in the color. We're gonna make little footy hills. So now we're gonna like shut off Bob. Bye Bob, love you. Because now after an hour of painting, I think I am comfortable with taking this in my own direction. So I'm gonna put some paint thinner on the brush. And then what I learned from Bob is if you wanna create reflections, you go like this. So I'm just gonna explain what I did. So this is the finished product. So basically what I did, I added some little river banks, blah de blah blah blah, some grass, pretty water, blah blah blah, added that over there. I feel like a winner. I really feel like a winner with this painting, so.